nervous, but I'm really excited to show you guys the car today. I just want to go over a few things that we think make this Civic great. So I want to start with my team. I've been with Honda for over 25 years and involved with many projects, but I've never been a part of a global team this passionate and committed to delivering something truly extraordinary. Now, before I get started, I wanted to acknowledge the vision of our global large project leader, Mr. Mitsuru Kuriya. He's been involved in Civic developments for 2 decades, including the development leader of the current generation European Civic 5-door. Kuriya-san couldn't be here today, but his incredible leadership was critical to this development, and his challenging spirit can be found in virtually every part of this epic new Civic. So we started this project by looking back at the history of the Civic. Previously, each generation had a nickname, at least internally to R&D. Civic nicknames used to be things like Super or Wonder, Sports, Grand, or Miracle. I actually worked on that Sports Civic when I lived in Japan right out of school. I was hired into Honda, and I moved to Japan for a couple years and worked on that. Suspension for the Civic. That was the first project that I ever worked on. So I feel like I've come a full circle from designing a small part on the Civic to being part of the leadership of this great new product. But somewhere along the line, something happened and we lost those exciting names, along with some of the vehicle's character. And we began to focus only on the North American mass market competitors like the Corolla. We wanted to change that. We wanted to make this Civic something truly special. So we started this development a little different than in the past, and it really starts with the goals that we set for ourselves. And that was simply to make the very best compact class car in the world. We wanted to do this by going back to Civic's roots of a sporty, fun-to-drive car that's still highly affordable, spacious, and efficient. So what did we need to change to accomplish this? Well, besides the chassis, the body, the interior, and 2 brand new engines, not that much. As a matter of fact, the turbo was not even slated to be ready for this 2016 Civic, but the team was very passionate about wanting to apply it from the outset. So through the hard work and cooperation of the powertrain division, management, and the team, we were able to introduce it here today to you. So our approach to the Civic was different than past developments, because we didn't just look at the usual competition in the North American market. We started by benchmarking the best C-segment cars in the world. That meant going to Europe, where we drove not just our competitive set, but luxury class C-segment vehicles from BMW, Mercedes, and Audi, like the Audi A3. Now, the Europeans are very good in terms of sporty handling and excellent road manners, including confidence-inspiring high-speed stability. And that's what we wanted for this new Civic. In fact, to get buy-in on our new direction, we took an early development prototype to Europe and had our top global executive drive it against European competitors at Autobahn speeds. With his approval of this challenging new direction, we then created 1 truly world-class Civic platform that would satisfy the world's most discerning customers and would underpin all Civics, meaning that this Civic platform, which was developed in America, will be the base for all Civics sold worldwide, the 2-door, 4-door, 5-door SI, and Type R. As a quick side note here, the Civic is the most collaborative global Honda, collaborative effort on a global scale for Honda ever. Each region developed the areas where their expertise lies. Japan did the powertrain. R&D in America did everything else, the chassis, body, interior, and the manufacturing was done in Canada. So it was truly a global effort. Now, our goal was to beat all the North American mass market competitors by targeting the European luxury vehicles. And we focused on these key areas: power, fuel economy, handling, packaging and styling, and even cabin quietness. Now, in order to do this, we developed a completely new platform. And we started by targeting a lower, sportier hip point. Now the hip point sets the direction for the complete platform. The current Civic sits relatively high and is a bit bus-like in its driving position. But this new Civic, by comparison, has the same low, sporty hip point as an Audi TT. Achieving this new sporty driving position meant completely rethinking the platform, lowering the floor, the instrument panel, and the engine, and completely re-engineering the suspension. With the other key aspect of this new platform is its low and wide stance. This Civic is nearly an inch lower and 2 inches wider. We also shortened the front overhang by more than an inch, which was a big engineering challenge, and lengthened the wheelbase, which pushes the wheels out to the corner. All of this helped us accomplish our goal to give this Civic a more premium feel and athletic stance. And even with that, through Honda's packaging magic, we are still able to achieve best-in-class interior space. So for styling, I'm not going to go into too much detail, but I just want to hit a few highlights. Actually, we're lucky enough today, the stylist who sketched this sketch, Mr. Tomori-san, is here from Japan joining us. So if you have any styling questions, please feel free to ask him. So with its low and wide stance, the styling portrays a muscular and athletic feel that gives a strong sense of acceleration even when the car is standing still. We pulled back the A-pillars to give better dash to axle ratio and a longer, more premium hood. And we have our LED headlight, our signature headlights and grille, and also LED signature taillights. And we even have LED headlights on our top trim, which is a first in the segment. So you'll be able to recognize the Civic day or night, coming and going. So our concept for the interior was tech center console, dynamic and wide IP, and premium quality materials. So the IP, or the interior that you see here, is not actually what we started with. We had a competition for the interior design. There were two models presented to the executives. And the global executive that I mentioned earlier didn't pick this model, he picked the other one. Now the designers and engineers from Japan and America were all working together in Japan on these models, getting ready for this event. And we actually all liked this interior, not the one that was picked. So we all pulled together and went underground for a few weeks and made quite a few refinements to it. And we went back to him and said, we understand your choice, but we would really like you to reconsider this interior because the team likes it much more. He changed his direction and his decision, and the team is so pleased with the beautiful interior that you're going to see today. So just a couple more highlights. For the center console, I just want to call out a couple interesting points. So we applied electronic parking brake to all versions of the Civic, and that gave us the design freedom to raise the entire center console, giving us a more comfortable position for the sliding armrest, and also increasing the volume underneath. Another new feature is our two-tier design. The top has perfect place to store your phone, and there is access holes in the back to guide the wires through for clean wire management. Now, of course, we have cup holders, but these cup holders are sliding, so you can hide them away under the armrest when you're not using them. And we have a sliding key fob storage. And when you open the center console, there's large storage area that can fit iPads or even a large water bottle. And of course, we are applying high quality materials to give that premium feel that we are targeting.